let me tell you something. कि जब वो बीबल मेक अ फिल्म ऑफ हिम एज अ टाइकून एज अ 30th richest man or whatever else it is. Very as an emotional human being to another emotional human being. How do you rate Mr. Rocky Mundal? What do you think? What essentially makes him the person that he is?
I think his humanity, humbleness, seva bhav are the things that we all know about, but maybe he doesn't talk about it. And
तो ये बताइए कि ओपी मुंजाल एक बहसियत एक इंसान और बहसियत एक इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट, क्या तो फर्क इंसान है या वो एक ही आदमी है जिसका वही जज्बा है, जिसके वही फीलिंग्स है?
I think with me and my father-in-law, Papa, we share a very beautiful relationship. I came into this household at the age of 19 as a bahu, as a very young bahu, 19 years. But since then, I have been seeing how he deals with people. I have myself evolved and grown as a person, seeing him deal with how to deal with people and imbibe so many things, you know, from him as a person. He's a, I would say, just a very, very transparent person. What he is like with everybody. He's not like, you know.
Why is he so good? What right has he got to be so good?
Basically, simplicity. He is a very, very human person, very, very down to earth. And for me, I think he is the apple of my eye, honestly. So many times, my husband always says, I think I have more of feelings than for him than I would say for anybody else. Even when he felt ill, I know what I went through in those week when he was in the ICU. In that 1 week, I forgot everything. With my children or with anybody, I was just standing outside and would be with him so that he would not eat with anybody. The nurses had a problem because he was so weak. He had this pneumonia attack. But the minute I think I would go in and walk and see him, he was like a very, very, absolutely emotional person at that time. And whatever I would give him or anything, he was ready to.
Can I tell you something? Huh? एक इंसान है, वो एक अपने खुद को बांट देता है, लोगों बांटता है वो अपने बिहेवियर से. तो आप कह रही हैं कि आप 19 साल की उम्र में उनसे उनके पास चलिए. जाहिर सी बात है कि उनकी चार बेटियां और हैं. तो जो ट्रीटमेंट को अपनी बेटियों के लिए रखते हैं और जो ट्रीटमेंट बहू के लिए रिजर्व्ड, उसमें क्या फर्क है?
आई थिंक इट्स that question, I would honestly say that he's a person who treats me more than his daughters. I have not got that treatment from my own father, what my father-in-law gives it to me. He has a very special corner for me. His daughters, of course, as a father, but me as a daughter-in-law, once he when I was with him at a party, he introduced me that this is my daughter-in-law. So somebody says, "Huh, daughter-in-laws are like daughters." He says, "No, I have one daughter-in-law. So, you know, I will say daughter-in-law." And he is very much of that thing that, you know, she's my daughter-in-law. But the love he gives me is much more than any daughter would expect.
Tell me something. Yeah. Obviously, he cherishes having
a daughter-in-law.
A daughter-in-law.
Yes.
The only son that he has.
Yeah.
What all does he shower on you in terms of affection, in terms of what is it that is reserved only for my bahu?
If he says a no to anybody. If my husband wants anything done, it will be done through me. Because he knows that I have a real special corner for him. I mean, he would not ever, till today, I've heard a no from him. Never.
Which means that if he wants Mr. Munjal, Gopi Munjal to do something, then he'll ask you to ask
him. He'll definitely ask me. And I will, you know.
Why don't you say, I'll just say that, you know, I become the wire media between the son and the father. Because
yeah, I become the wire media between the son and the father. And everyone knows that, you know, he does have a very, very soft corner for me.
You are from St. Mary's, I think.
Nainital.
Nainital, the hill school. And very swan, prestigious and so on. Gopi Munjal is a matric. Because he told me that when I finished my matric, I was brought by my brothers to come and work. So here you are, going to a swank school, swank college, an upmarket education, and here you come in touch with Mr. Gopi Munjal. And now you are saying you learned a lot from him. How is that possible?
See, education is one in on one side, but I think human values are much more. So I feel that his morals, values are par excellence. He's a basically anybody would have as a role model. Whatever one would dream to be, I ask my children that my future, what I would expect from them is how they should, is like Dadaji. I would love my husband to be like him. At this age, you would say, at the age of 75, I think now he is, he has such a peaceful sleep. And his vibrance, his peacefulness, everything shows on his face because he's such a clear human being.
Why are people so emotional about him? For instance, as I'm seeing your friend on camera,
yeah.
You almost have a teardrop in your eye while you're talking about him. You almost have a lump in your throat while you're describing your father-in-law. Tell me something. This father-in-law is not alone in being able to give a Bahu a good time in her life. The mother-in-law is a presence. It's a dual equation. How would you say that Mrs. Sudarshan Munjal and Mr. Gopi Munjal combined to ensure that Mrs. Charu Munjal, when she comes, finds a wonderful life? How did they ensure that?
With their love. They've given, you go anywhere in any spiritual discourse, everywhere they say the only thing that's important is love. And give a lot of love. And I think that definitely fits in their philosophy. They are full of love. And there are some people, you know, who believe in actions speak louder than words. I would say that definitely fits in there.
And what do you think is the, where does that all that affection and love spring from?
They're contented in life, basically.
Would you say that?
I said they are very, very contented in life. I feel they have no desires. They are absolutely enlightened by now, both mommy and papa. And now I think I have taken such a soft corner over the years with them that they definitely have a lot of confidence in me now. So, it's over the time and years that we have spent with each other.
50 years marriage.
15 years.
You are 15 years, your in-laws are 50 years.
Yeah.
And then you have your elder sister, elder
sister-in-law,
and you have other your family, larger family,
mm-hmm.
and so on. What have you learned from them in terms of creating a harmony around you so that everybody is happy and contented and in harmony with everyone else?
their philosophy, I would say, is give, love and respect. These three things, if you have it, you're a happy person. And I have seen that in my father-in-law, and I want to be like that.
He is known to be extremely generous, and he is also known to be a man who donates secretly. It's not as though he is donating to a name for himself.
He's a very generous and selfless person, and he definitely now wants to do without letting anybody know. He believes that not even the right hand should know or what the left hand is doing. So he is, and he has basically got, he's not doing it for people. He's basically doing it for him, his own self and his own contentment. And he's a Karam Yogi, you know. He believes that, you know, you ask him, and many people I've heard him say that in my heart it's written, in Hanuman's heart it was Ram, but in my heart it's Hero. So it's totally in his blood, and he is very proud of it.
ये बताइए कि इतना बड़ा आपका परिवार है, इतना, और अगर हम सिर्फ मुंजाल के बाहर भी देखें तो हम पाते हैं कि हीरो साइकिल्स का हर एक कर्मचारी, चाहे वो सुबह का दरबान हो या फैक्ट्री फ्लोर पे काम करने वाला आदमी हो, हर आदमी को ये विश्वास है, जो आपको विश्वास है कि बाबूजी मीन्स समथिंग पर्सनल टू देम. क्यों?
बिकॉज ही इज वेरी जेन्युइन पर्सन.
डोंट स्टार्ट विद बिकॉज.
या सॉरी. He's a very genuine person. He would do more for people who are, take it, be his dealers. I've gone for trips with him for these tours that he goes for his dealer conferences. For so many hours, he'll be sitting in his room with one family. If they have any problem, if they have any disputes, they share it openly with him. And he will definitely be of help for any family and get, take out so much time as if it's his own family and have them patch up, understand the problems, and everybody will come out with a smiling face because he
gets. Tell me something again that I would like to ask you. Is that you have a father?
Yeah.
You didn't have a father in law. So just as he had daughters and he wanted a daughter in law, so he doesn't want to mix up the two. Do you also have similar feelings that I have a father? Sometimes he'll scold me. But my father-in-law, I mean, he never scolded me. How do you find the difference between a father and a father-in-law?
See, a father-in-law, my father-in-law is, I'm telling you, I asked my father, he tells me that I don't talk for ages with my father, but if I don't talk one day without my father-in-law, my evening is not gone. I have to speak to him. And if suppose I speak to him after 2 days, some things I've got busy with, he will third day ask how many days have passed that we have last spoken. He counts every minute if I don't speak to him. So I feel that his love has you know, made me such an enriched person and so confident in this life, being a lone bahu, having my son, husband as the only son, and have in such a big family. It was like, you know, everywhere I used to feel that going anywhere I'm the only one person here in Delhi, but with the confidence and backing my father-in-law and my mother-in-law have given me, I thank God, you know. I'm very, very proud and happy that I've got such wonderful parents.